All right, so here we are in the application itself. We're gonna talk about those features that separate Skybell from some of its competitors. So, first being, you get 1080p at 5x digital zoom. Now, this is a plus and a minus because for the most part, depending on your Wi-Fi signal and location, you may not be able to use the 1080. I have it set for the 720. I'll show you where that is later. It doesn't look terrible. Now, if you have a strong Wi-Fi signal, you can use the 1080, which will be great. It has a motion sensor. So I pointed it out on the camera itself. That motion sensor, for my experience with it, is hit or miss. It will get people coming in and out of my house. It'll get people that push the button. But further out, like by this car, or even walking up my walkway or my neighbor's walkway there, it does not trigger, and I don't know why. I did do some reading where it might be a issue with my chime box or my transistor that converts the high power from my fuse box to low power for this. It worked. I didn't notice it, but now I kind of wonder. So I may in the future actually change those out. And if it does change, I will come back and update this with another video. But right now, motion sensing, not the best with this. Live monitoring is kind of cool. You would press that play button and that will bring you into the live monitoring mode. Now, I will say one thing. When you go to live monitor, what happens is the light underneath and on top, as I pointed out earlier, will actually turn on white, letting people know that you are actively looking through it. So for me, all those people down the block would know if I'm actively looking through my video doorbell, even if I have the LEDs turned off, which I currently do. Free recording, that's also great. You get free cloud storage of things that you actively record, or motion, manual, and doorbell presses. You get to hold on to those for a week, so that's pretty cool. You can have multiple users on a single account or multiple devices on a single account. It has hear and speak, so they on the outside can hear me speaking and I on the inside can hear them speaking, like this. All right, testing two-way audio, just cutting my wife out of there because this is how she agreed to help me. This is a test of the Skybell Trim.
Hello, how are you doing?
Hello, how are you doing?
Next is activity history. Again, that is on here. I will show you where that is so it'll have all of the activity that it saved. Colored night vision. Now, colored night vision to me is a plus and a minus. And again, I will roll in some sample footage. The colored night vision has its limitations. I have active night vision with my Wyze cams. And in some instances, I like that a little better, especially when you see the light that's always on because it's a street light, kind of makes it more difficult to see people walking past until they get up really close or my stoop light triggers. You have quiet mode, talk about that a little later. And last that I'll discuss before going through things, theft guarantee. So if somebody takes your Skybell, it will be replaced. So, main page here shows you the date and time, configuration, play button. So we are going to start with pressing play. That will actively bring up my outside, given a second. On occasion, I do get this stream could not be established, but going back and refreshing, generally brings that up. Now, part of that is right now I'm dealing with some fairly annoying internet issues, but this is a live stream to my house. You have take a snapshot, you have push and talk, that will let you hear the person, and then you have this hang up. You also have digital zoom. Now, again, you can flip this and get a larger view. You can tap and the buttons go away. That talk is always there. I kind of wish that it could go away, but you've got a nice wide fisheye view, which in my case shows me my driveway, my neighbor's driveway, and then the neighbor driveway. So I can pretty much get a wide view of everything that's going on, which is really nice. Now, what I will say, if you do not press the hang up button. And even if you swipe this closed, the doorbell will remain sending information through your network. So just be aware of that. If you don't hang up, you're still going to be using data. Coming across the top, you have all of your notifications. I had to scroll down to get to some that actually didn't have me, but these are also clips that would show you kind of like the night vision that I was talking about. So pressing on it will open up that video and then you could watch it. Now we're going to go back. If you wanted to download or save something, you would swipe to the left and then you can delete, share, or download. You also have this option up here, which will allow you to filter for specific things. If you had multiple cameras, motion events, button presses, or on demand. Those on demands are if you actively look through the video doorbell by pressing that play button. Now, it does take a new snapshot every time you look through it, so this changes as the day goes on. Next, over here is profile, and in there you have sign out, my devices, add a new skill because you can add new skills. It is compatible with Nest for now, probably not anymore, IFTTT, and Gibbo. Never heard of that, but it works. You've got your FAQ support and legal. That's all that you get from there. Now, I will say during the setup process, what I did really appreciate on just about every screen, there was a little icon that was, hey, do you need help? Push this button and you could talk to somebody live. Now, I did not, but you could if you run into problems during your setup. Back to the front door here, we're gonna press on the options menu and that's gonna bring us to device name. I have it as front door, notifications. So you can be notified if you get a button press or a motion detection. And there's that icon I was talking about for help. Information, last check-in firmware, serial number, model number, status, connective quality, signal strength, bit rate. It shows you networking and some other stuff down there. We're not gonna do that. LED. So the LED status light is just that. It is the LED on top and on the button. You can select what color you want it to be. This is the color, you just kind of drag it around and it will change. So if we come over here and I select red, the camera outside will be red. If we come back here and select green, camera outside will change to green. I will say that the green color in particular is a little tricky to see in the daylight. Which is why we kind of stuck with this teal color. My wife likes that, so that's what we went with. You can select different levels of brightness. Now, some of those are easier to see at whatever levels. Again, I keep the LED off only because I don't want people seeing down my block that I have something on my front door that they should maybe be wondering about. Indoor chime on and off. This is really nice. So this is that quiet mode. Let's say you don't want your chime box to go off because your wife is sleeping and you don't want her to kill you, but you're expecting that next review package from Amazon. If you come in here and turn the chime off, the outdoor will still ring and the phone will ring, but not the actual physical chime box. Great thing to save your marriage. Outdoor chime is just that. If they push the button, you can allow them to hear a chime as well. So you could set the volume for that, low, medium, and high. Good stuff. Motion detection. Again, I have it on, I have it for high. It's not doing what it should be doing. I'll change out probably the chime box and the other component to see if that helps and update later. Image quality right here. I have it set for 720 better and that gets me a perfectly acceptable video quality. None of that I will mention is in 1080p. All in 720 better. Speaker volume, so again, the exterior so they can hear you is your speaker volume. And in this case, I just have it set for medium, which has functioned perfectly well. Integration, don't have any. Sharing, don't have any, but you could manage if you did.